What up, it's your boy Trey Little, and I'm about to do my first Q&A on YouTube. I got the questions from Instagram, so we about to get into it, man. Make sure y'all like this video, make sure y'all subscribe, and I'm about to do my first Q&A. Hopefully, if this goes well, I'll do more. Make sure y'all follow me on Instagram at Trey Little to ask me questions to be a part of these Q&A. So let's get it. First question from Sabir, S-A-B-I-R. What motivated me? So what motivated me to get where I'm at is just wanting a better life for my family, for myself, and wanting to impact my city, Detroit, and just wanting to do something amazing in life. You know, I come from poverty. I come from Section 8, government assistance. And, you know, I lost my dad when I was 4. He was shot, killed. Mama had me at 15. So, like, I wanted something better. You know what I mean? I didn't want the lifestyle that I seen everybody else around me struggling to get out of. A lot of people wanted to get out of it. And I decided to, like, be a part of the solution. So that motivated me. And then watching people like 50 Cent, a lot of the artists I look up to, like T Grizzly, NF, John Bell, and Young Thug, seeing that life, watching their vlogs, like, man, I want to get a tour bus and go on tour one day. You know what I mean? Somebody, Austin Gilbert, said, describe the mental pain when growing up in the hood or the ghetto of Detroit. So the mental pain was, like, not being able to get close to people, not feeling like I could get, you know, close to people because they could lose their life quick and I might not see them again. So it was like feeling like I can't get attached to people. You know what I mean? Like, I felt like to have a friend and have them, you know, die or lose their life like that is tough. You know, and the PTSD of hearing gunshots, seeing police cars, seeing ambulance come pick up people who were killed. Like, all that kind of stuff is just like, it'll mess you up. It's like a war zone. Imagine living in war, and then on the way to school, you got people targeting you, you know, willing to take your life. So, like, it was tough. It was really tough growing up. You know, we had some good moments as well, but remembering, like, man, people lost their life a lot. You can't get attached because some of your best friends might lose their life, and some of my best friends that I used to play Xbox with, you know, end up getting killed and stuff like that. So, it ain't no joke, you know. So, why is your name Trey Little? So, I don't really like to say my full name. I don't know, just because, like, I don't know, just because, you know. But my name is Trey because that's the name I had growing up in the hood, because it's short for my full name. And don't be saying no racist junk trying to guess my name, being ridiculous or rude. But Trey is short for my full name. So let's see. Somebody said, love you. That's what's up. What's my favorite song I made? Millie's Angel. Let's see, favorite song right now was Mask On because it's one of the newest ones. You know what I mean? Like, anytime I make something new is one of my favorite, because all my other songs like Rage, Mad Lit, I love those songs, but when you perform those over and over and over, you get tired of hearing it. So usually the latest song I release is one of my favorite ones. You know what I mean? So right now it'll be Mask On. Let's see, where do I see myself in 5 years? Really good question. So some of the goals I had was hit 1 million on TikTok, just did that, hit 10K on Instagram, already did that, I'm almost at 22,000 followers. I want to hit 100,000 subscribers on YouTube, but I see myself making over 6 figures in 5 years by, you know, having multiple streams of income. I want my YouTube to be slapping to where, you know, I got the plaque, I'm over 100,000 subscribers, making, you know, at least like $5,000-$10,000 a month from YouTube. Getting endorsement deals from TikTok and Instagram, of course verified on all platforms, and I see myself touring around the world, you know what I mean, doing massive shows, possibly charting on Billboard. If I don't chart, I ain't with all the industry stuff, because sometimes that stuff is super hard to get if you're independent. So if I don't chart, it is what it is, but I see myself touring, traveling, being verified, and meeting a lot of y'all, you know what I mean. That's like one of my biggest priorities, you know. So let's see, what made you want to start pursuing music? I just love music, you know what I mean? It's something that I've always wanted to do. I looked up to like 50 Cent and stuff like that. And rapping was the thing that I just loved, because I was able to channel my voice and, you know, do what I love, you know what I mean? Like, rapping was a thing that a lot of kids wanted to do in my neighborhood. And I felt like people was listening to me when I rapped. You know what I mean? My bad, I'm answering a text. I'm answering a text message, my bad. So I felt like people listen when I started rapping and stuff like that. You know, growing up in the streets, you know, everybody was tough, everybody, a lot of people was thugs, and they ain't really listen to a young guy. But when I started spitting, it got people attention, you know what I mean? Somebody said, when you grew up in the hood, what did you learn from that? I learned how to hustle. I learned how to survive. I learned how to basically hustle and take little and make it a lot. You know what I mean? For instance, like, if I get a little bit of money, I know how to stretch it. I know how to invest it. I know how to turn it into more money. I also learn how to survive. I learn how to protect myself. I learn how to communicate, how to motivate and influence people. Because when you grow up in the streets, you got to think fast. Sometimes you be in so many life or death situations, you got to figure out how to be quick on your feet. So I learned how to be quick on my feet. I learned how to be bold. Even when I have fear, I learned how to push through that fear. You know what I mean? So that's what a few things I learned from growing up in the hood. How long does it usually take to come up with lyrics for a song? I can come up with lyrics like right now, sitting doing a video on YouTube, because that's what I do, answering Q&A's up on Instagram, feeling like I am the man, dread shaking, feeling like a Jamaican, like stuff like that. You know what I mean? I can just freestyle off top. Like it's really not that bad, you know. Sometimes I struggle, like I don't really like writing lyrics like that. Somebody said, how was school for me? So I always struggled in school. I had all D's and F's throughout all elementary, middle school, high school, until I graduated. And then I graduated with all A's and B's because I built relationships with the counselors, teachers, and all that. And they really messed with me. So, you know, I'm still cool with some of them. And shout out to Ms. Rush from Kennedy Counselor Truman. Let's get it. But I built relationships with them, and it helped me get extra credit, where they'll show me like, yo, if you do this, do that, do this after school class, boom, you'll get caught up and that kind of stuff. So I graduated with all A's and B's. But DPS, Detroit Public School, felt like jail. You know what I mean? Like, felt like jail. And it was tough just because it was like gangs, different races, gangs, like white, like Hispanics, blacks. Like, it was just split up by like so many different ethnic groups and like gangs, and like it was just crazy, you know. So Detroit public school was rough. Till I went to high school in the suburbs, it was a lot better. But then I was the problem, I was the threat that people scared of. Let's see, how do you manage to be creative and talk about different topics in every song? I just try to find stuff to talk about, like find stories from my life. I try to talk about current things. Some of the best music I make, like the George Floyd, I Can't Breathe, that was just a freestyle. I was expecting just a vent, you know what I mean? And I freestyled that, and it was out of emotion, and the song blew up, you know what I mean? 150,000 views, like millions of views on TikTok. Like, yeah, it's going crazy, but that was out of a genuine pain in my heart, you know. Would you come to Canada to do a concert? I would love to. I did a show in Canada in Windsor. It was amazing. Really hope to travel. Like, I love Canada, love Toronto. Like, man, let's get it, you know. Do you think the community can positively rebuild, or do we require the government? I think us as the people, us as the citizen, it should be up on us. We shouldn't wait for the president. We shouldn't wait for the police. We shouldn't wait for none of that. We should be on top of building our community, building relationships, investing money. That's why I'm trying to get more money. That's why I'm trying to get my platform up, so I can invest in my neighborhood. Right now I got the voice, the followers to be the voice. Now I need the money to invest in my neighborhood, so we can help with the poverty rate, which slows down the crime. Anytime there's poverty, there's a lot of crime. What is my biggest inspiration coming to Australia? Like I said, man, biggest inspiration is just seeing what I want to do and where I want to be in my future, and helping people out in need, you know. How do you handle disrespect? So when you put yourself out there, like, you're gonna deal with hate, but at the end of the day, the thing is, you gotta understand, when you put yourself out there, like, you're gonna deal with the hate from people just because they're not doing what you're doing, and you're doing what they want to be doing. So they're gonna show hate to you just because you're putting yourself out there. You know what I mean? Hate just shows that, like, you're doing something right. And just like the compliments, you're going to get the hate that comes with it. The more people that know about you, the more people going to love you, the more people going to hate you. So what you got to do is, like, not let the compliments get to your head, and don't let the criticism basically get to your heart or whatever. So, like, if people compliment you, that's cool, that's what's up. And then if people criticize you, it is what it is. Like, just say thank you, you know what I mean? Like, to the compliments, and then when you hear the criticism, try to learn from it and just keep going. Like, always do what you love and don't let nobody hold you back, you know what I mean? Like, for real, for real. Let me see what else we got. How do you feel? how do you feel being a black individual that has a lot of power? So I think that's a good question, because I always like to let people know I got a certain privilege with being an artist. Yes, I still can be targeted by people who don't know who I am, the cops who don't care about who I am. Like in Detroit, a lot of cops know who I am, so I'm usually chilling, feeling like I can do what I want to do in my city, to a certain degree, you know what I mean? Obviously, I'm not going to break laws and do nothing crazy, but I can feel like I can walk around and have a privilege that I wish more black people had. So what I like to do is communicate on behalf of my people and of my city, the people who aren't in a position that I'm in. I try to bridge those gaps and go to people in power in the city and let them know, like, yo, since y'all respect me, here's what the other people in my community need. You know what I mean? So it feels good. And part of it feels like, wow, this what it would feel like to be someone who isn't profiled by the police. You know what I mean? It'll be dope if I can go to the suburbs where I'm a minority and feel like I have that kind of respect. But if I go to the suburbs, a lot of time the police, man, they be on edge if they pull up on me. You know what I mean? So unfortunately, but in Detroit, where it's a lot of black cops, it feels good because a lot of them respect me. And I'm just glad to be in positions with people who are either rich, millionaires, like, and have that kind of respect, man, like, for real, like, it's amazing, you know, to think that somebody who come from the hood and come from the streets, that can have the situation, the kind of power that I have. Let's see. Let's see. Somebody said, how do you feel like with people rooting? But I think he meant rioting. Thing is, so many people getting hung up on riots, blah, blah, blah. But then you got to understand, like, y'all got to realize why people are doing it. Why are people doing this? Ask that question. Figure out why people are rioting. No, I don't condone rioting, but that shouldn't be the topic right now. You know what I mean? People care more about the buildings and protecting buildings than they do about protecting unarmed black men and women who are getting killed. So, yeah, that's what I'm gonna say about that. A regret and a mistake. I think I need to just start focusing more on the present and not looking so much of the future of, oh, I want to be here, I want to do this, I want to do that, and forgetting to have fun in the moment. That's some of, like, my biggest regrets. Enjoying my family and friends in the moment and not looking so much for the future, feeling like I can't live unless I get to this point in my career. But not worrying about the money and stuff, but enjoying my everyday life. Last question. Let's see. Somebody said, how old when I started music? Like 9. And then I'm going to answer this one. What advice do you have on starting music? So, make it every day. Start on your phone if you don't got a studio. But I would highly advise you get a laptop, a computer, or whatever, and some cheap recording equipment. And then start recording music. Putting it up there, don't overthink it. Try to get the best quality that you can. Go on YouTube and type in how to create a home studio. Eventually, you don't want to use the phone because people aren't going to take your song serious if it's recorded on the phone. If you need to, grab your phone, record a video, stand in a bin, and I got to go get it uploaded on YouTube, TikTok, all that stuff. Market it to people. You want to put yourself out there. Don't be scared. Keep pushing it. Do it over time. If you do anything over extended amount of time, you will succeed in it. You know what I mean? Like, make sure you work hard at something over and over. Don't do it for 5-6 months and give up. Don't even do it for a year and just give up. If you want to be successful at something, you do it all your life, you will be successful. If you stay consistent, you learn and you grow. The human mind is capable of learning, growing, and doing some creative stuff. So if you stay consistent, you will be successful. Always remember that. Thank you.